A young and beautiful woman with dreams of making it in Hollywood.
She was last seen near her apartment a week ago.
Family and friends have not heard from 25-year-old Adea Shabani since February 23rd.
It's a Hollywood story with a grim ending. A beautiful and hopeful starlet.
I would like to know, Rodolfo.
Seemingly vanishing without a trace. 25-year-old Adea Shabani. Last seen on February 23rd, 2018.
This was her corner coffee shop, and then she went to the Stella Adler Acting Academy, which is also nearby. So this is really is the ground zero for that kind of Hollywood ambition.
The story of her disappearance is now at the center of a blockbuster true crime podcast to live and die in L.A., hosted by Rolling Stone reporter Neil Strauss. The story unfolds in real time as he works with private investigator Jayden Brant to piece together what he says happened to Shabani.
Just to put things in context, this is where Adea Shabani lived. And think about it, you've come here from Macedonia. You always have this dream that you're going to be a star one day.
This is the last place she was seen.
It's the last place she was seen and seen with her boyfriend, Chris Potts.
This all began back in February 2018 when the aspiring actress from Macedonia first vanished. Her friend sounded the alarm to the LAPD. Concerned she wasn't merely on a road trip with Chris Spots, her boyfriend at the time.
We just want her back.
Desperate for answers and feeling frustrated by the LAPD, friends and family hired Brant, a private investigator with experience in Los Angeles law enforcement, to investigate her disappearance and stir up publicity.
We are very active in the case. I've been working it since late yesterday and following all the leads as they arrive.
Brant brought Strauss in, hoping, he says, to continue giving the disappearance media attention.
So I don't know, you might have seen it in the news. She was in Hollywood. She was last seen on Friday.
Which this Friday or the Friday, like the week before?
No, this Friday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
And since that call, the two have been working as a team for more than a year on the case, filling in critical gaps in the mystery.
It appeared to be the case pretty early on that there was foul play involved in this case and that it was likely a homicide.
They say that boyfriend, Spots, became a suspect early in their investigation, a fellow actor seen here in his acting reel.
I'll confess. I'll tell the police what you did.
They say he was engaged to another woman at the time of his relationship with Shabani. A month after her disappearance, Shabani's body was found in Northern California. She died of blunt force trauma, and police reportedly went looking to speak to Spots.
So if he did do it, the question is, what was the motive?
Eyewitness News has learned the man police say shot and killed himself following a pursuit that ended in Corona Thursday night was Adea Shabani's boyfriend.
Unfortunately, the motive may never be known. Spots shot and killed himself after a chase with California Highway Patrol.
This situation is highly unique in that both there was a homicide occurred and that our primary suspect at that time committed suicide. You know, it changes our ability to investigate because we don't have the ability to actually speak with our suspect.
Now there's two families devastated by this, Adea's and Chris's.
And now Spots' family is trying to help Strauss dig for the truth.
Shared his information, said we just want to know what happened. Like, we know Chris is a good kid. He's never hurt anyone in his life. We know this can't be him, but we also want to know the truth, and we trust that you're objective about it.
Which includes, they say, handing over his digital footprint.
They gave us his account information, and unbeknownst to most people, Google is not just tracking you, but it's very easy to find it yourself, or anyone who has access to your account can find out your exact movements, everywhere you've been, down to the minute. It's insane. And it just so happened that Chris Spots never turned his phone off. So we were able to see the moment he picked up Adea, the day she disappeared.
Google data providing a map of Spots' movement with incredibly precise details, something cell phone data had failed to provide.
You're in Chris's,
we're in Chris's
Google account.
Holy moly. So this is like anybody can pull this up who has a Gmail account or any email account.
Yeah. I'm almost loath to say it, because I feel like if somebody goes missing or something happens, they've turned this off, we won't find out what happened. We wouldn't know what happened if Chris had this off.
The data, Strauss says, began to give him a TikTok of the last day Shabani was seen alive.
Her phone bill data stops at 12:50. You know, he arrives in her house at 12:48. So you can just pretty much figure out that he came in around this time and something happened with the phone between them. Maybe he asked her to turn it off, maybe he turned it off in himself. but we know that's connected to him arriving there.
They say that the data also shows Spots' phone in the area where her body would be found. As the team leads its own parallel investigation, Strauss is outspoken about the lack of law enforcement resources for missing persons cases.
If you go to the LAPD website, it says what to do if someone goes missing that you love or a loved one. And the thing to do is, it says we get, I don't know, tens of thousands and thousands of these cases a year, and most likely they'll come back. If they don't come back, contact us. We'll take a report. However, we can't really put our full investigatory power behind it because there's no proof it's a homicide, they're just missing. So if we want to find that person, hire a private investigator. So they're basically telling people, we don't have the capacity to deal with it. And you can't just only rely on the police.
At the time of Spots' death, the LAPD said he was responsible for Shabani's murder.
We also believe that Mr. Spots, Christopher Spots, was somehow involved in her death, and we believe this to be a homicide.
The LAPD now considers the case closed, saying it fully investigated the case and is confident it found the killer. Nobody else was charged as being involved, and they now consider the case closed.
It's off-road.
But with what they say is Spots' Google location data in hand, Strauss and his team aren't satisfied with that conclusion and have been retracing the days leading up to his road trip with Shabani, convinced that he may have had help in her death. They brought us to a hardware store and an apartment building in North Hollywood, which they believe to be two of Spots' last stops before picking up Shabani.
She told her friend that she was going to the funeral of Chris Spots' uncle. And really, where suspicion started to get raised was when he called Chris Spots' family and they said he doesn't have an uncle who passed away. We know that Chris Spots stopped here on his way to see Adea, and if we can find the person we stopped to visit, we can find out what he was doing there. So we're checking to see the current tenants to see if it's someone who's come up on Chris's phone bill or his list of friends or whatever it may be. What we're really trying to nail down are some of the last pieces of information.
This is the latest hit in the booming industry of true crime multimedia, following the likes of Serial.
It's Serial, one story told week by week.
Netflix's Making a Murderer, HBO's The Jinx. And about 1 million listeners are downloading this podcast's episodes every week.
What is the secret sauce there?
To me, I think it's like curiosity and obsession. It's all unfolding in real time. You know things before maybe the police do. You know things before sometimes the families do. Like, so I think there's a part of it that really is almost just a documentary.
A tragic truth, but one that isn't deterring Strauss and Brant, who still hope to uncover the truth behind a heartbreaking loss.
And you can listen to all the episodes of To Live and Die in LA for free on Apple Podcasts. Tune in on May 17th for the finale.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.